quiz of everything. Yes, you heard right. This is the Big Fat Quiz of Everything, a special edition of the Big Fat Quiz in which we ask questions about absolutely everything that's ever happened right up to now. Tonight, there'll be questions about literally everything, except, of course, Mohammed. He gets a pass. We're going to be asking the big questions like, who are we and why are we here? In my case, it's Jimmy Carton for the money. Fine, you knew that already. Remember, you can play along at home. All you need is a comprehensive grasp of quantum mechanics, a thorough understanding of ancient Greek, or, failing that, a couple of knob gags. Speaking of which, let's meet our teams. She plays a manipulative, narcissistic, work-shy kleptomaniac in Brooklyn Nine-Nine. He plays a manipulative, narcissistic, work-shy kleptomaniac in The Jonathan Ross Show. It's Chelsea Peretti and Jonathan Ross. She's the queen of the bake-off, he's the king of the jack-off. It's Mel Giedroyc and Jack Whitehall. It's every woman's dream if the woman in question is dreaming about a geography teacher and his pet crow. It's Richard Arwani and Noel Fielding. Jonathan, Chelsea, lovely to have you on the show.
Thank you,
Jimmy.
Chelsea, you're on an Emmy-winning comedy show in America. You're better than this.
Thank you, Johnny.
Have you got a team name?
We were talking about a name, weren't we? And we thought, because Chelsea stars in a police procedural comedy, Brooklyn Nine-Nine, we could have cops in the title. And because I'm a cheeky but lovable rogue, I could be a sort of thieving character. So we've come up with the name.
Cops and Robbers.
Jonathan, can you even say that?
Well...
Well, no, Chelsea won't be aware, but Jonathan has, I don't know...
A speech impediment.
What the... Hold on, we haven't even started the show. You've just arrived in the country.
Are you aware of any of Jonathan's work back in America?
No, I scanned the names on the show and I didn't know any of you, but I was just excited... to get a free trip to London, so thank you, dear strangers.
Right, now, you've got, Jonathan, a degree in history, right? So you've got a passion for history.
No, I have a degree in history because I filled in the application form at university incorrectly.
What did you want to study?
I wanted to study English.
You read the form wrong?
No.
Is your love of history the reason you're wearing period clothing this evening?
Jack Merritt, you got a team name?
Cakes and Hoes.
Come on, no. We didn't agree on hoes.
Okay. Custard Junkies.
Everything sounds like an awful porn film. You've got half a degree in art history from Manchester?
Yep.
Yeah, I hope show business works out, because you've got nothing to fall back on.
I'll be fine if this doesn't work, honestly. I'm going to take up baking. Professionally.
Yeah, you'll be fine.
I want to be on the Bake Off.
Of course you can.
Because I want to be on the Bake Off, I want to be the first person ever to give Mary Berry hash brownies. And I'm not talking about, like, nice mellow hash. I'm talking about that sketchy stuff. I want her locked in a fridge with a colander on her head. She thinks aliens are trying to steal her recipe for sourdough.
Noel, Richard, have you got a team name?
Team Falafel.
Russell Brand was not available.
You two have played on the quiz before and you've never won. You feel confident?
Thank you.
Just saying.
We've won, haven't we? I won with Russell.
No, you didn't win. You were given the special prize.
You need a ladder to get to the top of your collar. Is our team name.
The ladder collars.
I can't have that. That's a horrible thing to...
Just because you need a hard hat to put your shirt on... Do you need scaffolding around it? Why is it so high?
I can't believe you're sitting next to Noel Fielding and you're making jokes about my shirt.
That's how bad your shirt is.
I look like a trendy art teacher. Yeah. Hey, kids, don't call me Mr. Fielding, yeah? Call me Noel.
You'll call the ladder collars, you're the custard junkies, cops and wobbers.
Can I put on my lucky mascot? Heseltine, the bear.
Can I smell Heseltine?
Yes, if you want.
Bears always smell weird, don't they?
My father made me call my childhood teddy bear Heseltine because he said... Well, he made me say that I had to name it after a prominent... What are you doing?
Nothing.
Can you guys have a bit of respect, please?
Should we get on with the quiz? What do we think?
Yeah, definitely.
OK, let's get on with the quiz. Our first round is all about history. Genghis Khan conquered the known world in the 12th century. For many Asians, the period of Khan's rule involved violence, poverty and hardship. It's known now in North Korea as the good old days. In 1837, at the tender age of 18, Queen Victoria was crowned. Many people thought the teenager was too young to be queen, to which Victoria replied, "Sharp, you don't even know me." Of course, it wouldn't be a quiz without questions, I sound. For our first question, it's over to my favourite girl group of all time. It's Little Mix.
Oh, I love Little Mix.
Hello, Jimmy.
Now, as you know, we had a number one song called Black Magic.
Yes, but if we had started singing that in the 17th century, we might have gotten a bit of trouble with the witch hunters.
Yes.
Yep. Can your teams name three methods that were used for telling whether a woman was a witch?
What is methods?
Why are they trying to steal those pillows?
So, three ways to tell if someone was a witch.
Oh, yeah. Oh, I know. Oh,
well, write it down.
Not that kind of quiz.
Well done, Mal.
Right.
Children often think I'm a witch. They're right.
You are aware you write the answers, not draw them.
Sorry, I'm just getting used to this technology with the pen.
Yeah. It's not the newest of technologies, the pen, is it?
How much have you been hanging out with Mary Berry? This newfangled pen?
Sorry, lads.
Have a look at this recent reconstruction of a very famous historical figure. All I want to know is who is it?
It is a radical new solution to this mystery. An illness passed on to him from earlier generations and made worse by being the product of incest.
Thin Vin Diesel, isn't it?
Jonathan.
You what?
It is not Vin Diesel.
That's that history major.
Yes.
OK, as always on the Big Fat Quiz, the children of Mitchellbrook Primary School in Neasden act out one of their unconventional school plays. Which historical event are they acting out here?
I'm going to bake a cake. Ooh, I'm so tired. Me too. Let's go outside, OK?
Buckets.
Get a gunpowder.
Gunpowder? Oh no.
Don't worry, I will rebuild everything.
Yay!
Dear Diary, today was lamentable.
And they say our dramas can't compete with the Americans. Take that, Chelsea.
Wow.
For our next question, take a look at these emojis. I want to know what famous event they represent.
If you want to erase anything, it's voice activated, yes. By the way.
Erase.
Poet is all over this show.
Jack!
Sorry, mate. That's not something.
That's a game I actually play with my dad. I cannot believe that worked. My dad is 75, so it's fine with him.
God.
It's amazing. I tell my dad everything. Every new bit of kit they get in their house, I tell him it's voice activated. You have not known true joy until you've seen a 75-year-old man tell an electric blanket to go fuck itself.
Okay, have you got something?
It's got to be that. It's got to be that.
All right. In the 10th century, Harald Gormson was the king of Denmark and Norway. I think we all knew that.
Oh, yeah.
His nickname, written in Viking runes, features on every modern-day mobile phone. What is it?
Features on every mobile
phone. Every mobile phone.
Everyone.
OK, everyone got the answers?
Yes.
OK, let's have some answers. Why not? OK, first, Little Mix asked you three methods witch hunters used to tell if a witch was a witch.
Yes.
What did you get, Jonathan, Chelsea?
Well, Chelsea got all these immediately. One is floating, right? They would put them in the river to see if they floated. If a woman floated back to the surface, she was a witch. But of course, if you weren't a witch, you'd still.
It's a flawed system.
Maybe
because
a bit
she
harsh.
Sinks to the bottom and dies, and you're like, yay, she's innocent.
Okay, so what have you written?
Piss cake.
100% right.
And finally.
Prick.
Yes.
They would prick their finger if they did not bleed. They were in fact a witch.
Absolutely right. Are you? You're slightly scaring me with your
witchy eyes. Or was it a different feature?
Can you explain the piss cake?
No.
It was basically a witch's victim. They would extract the urine from, put it in a cake, and feed it to one of the pets, like a cat or a dog. If the pet died, then the person was obviously a witch.
Oh my God! Bake Off next series, Piss Cake Week.
That is absolutely right. So you got three right
on
there, Jonathan, Chelsea. What did you put, Jack Mel?
First, ask politely. Second, ask firmly. And if that doesn't work, drill a hole in her head.
I got a bit annoyed because Jack was writing down lots of comedy answers and I was writing down all the serious answers. There's a bit of division in this team. I drew an extra nipple, I drew a cat, and I wrote the word muttering, because that was also something
yes,
that they could be...
And I'm the childish one.
Yeah, well, no...
Just saying.
If you talk to yourself, that was another way that they thought you were a witch. Noel and Richard, what have you got for this?
Verbal confirmation.
Weirdly, that is right. If another witch said you were a witch, you're a witch.
Exactly.
Okay, we made that up.
I'm a witch.
We'll take it.
I'm a witch, so if I say you're a witch, you're fucked. Yeah.
Correct.
You're not, though.
Sink,
you've got no
sink.
Magical powers at all.
You're not even a warlock.
You're not even a witch's tit.
You're
a witch.
It's a weird insult. Why am I insulted? Yes, I am a witch's tit. Who's winning? So, verbal confirmation, what else you got?
Pets.
If you had a pet, people thought it was a familiar, they thought you were a witch.
OK, I think points all round.
Thank you.
Yeah. People know how to deal with witches. Good news.
Yeah. You gotta do it.
The extra nipple.
OK, yeah. Question two. Recent reconstruction of a famous historical figure, what did you put?
Oscar Pistorius.
Hundred percent wrong.
I put Dynamo. And then we put King Tut.
Yes. We just put Greg Wallace. He's on a diet.
No, sorry.
He looks great.
We didn't put Greg Wallace. You put Greg Wallace.
What did you go for, Jonathan, Chelsea?
We went with King Tut as well. But now I'm looking at him, I imagine if he didn't have a beard, that's what Jack Whitehall would look like in a nappy, isn't it?
It is Tutankhamun. Question three. You saw the children of Mitchellbrook Primary School acting out a famous historical event. What was it?
Bake Off Arson Week.
Hang on, Noel and Richard have something to add to that joke.
We wrote Bake Off Pilot, Boosh Pilot.
Nice.
And then we did Great Fire of London. So, in a way, there's a three-tier... It gets more boring as you go to the right.
Can I just say, I put Great Fire of London in brackets underneath Jack's
OK,
good
we can see that. And then Chelsea and Jonathan...
So we went with... we just went Great Fire of London, but to show that we're kind of, you know, living in the moment, we spelled it LDN, like Dizzy Rascal spells it.
Nice. Do you know what the Mayor of London was reported to say on hearing of the Great Fire of London?
Oh, shit.
It was about women pissing on it or something.
He said a woman might piss it out.
I tell you what, though, flour is highly flammable.
Good to know.
It's totally flammable. Yeah. If you do an experiment at home, well, maybe not at home, but in a hangar that no one's interested in.
Yeah.
And then.
Got one then.
And then.
I'm right there.
The first thing you need is a hangar.
Just a wing of your house that no one lives in.
Throw up some flour.
Yes.
Throw it up so it's sort of, you know, dissipating into the air. And then light a match and watch the whole hangar go up.
Sorry, you're advocating arson. Obviously, don't try that at home.
Sorry.
Where am I within this flame ball that I've done? I've thrown the flour up, I light the match.
And then that's the last thing you see.
then you get out of your get out of your.
I can't run faster than fire, Mel. I tried it.
So you all got that far of London, great. I showed you a series of emojis which represented a historical event. What did you think it was?
We didn't know the name of the boat, did we? So you've got to give us some leeway on that. But there was a, it was quite recent history. There was a cruise, quite a famous thing, where all the toilets broke on the cruise.
I mean, could not have been more wrong. Jack, Mel?
I think it's
the
Titanic.
Titanic's a pretty good guess. Noel, Richard?
We went with Titanic and then we wrote joke of some kind, kind of as a, as a placeholder.
Then we ran out of time.
Yeah.
But we are still working on that.
We're going to come back to that joke at some stage.
Well, look forward to that.
Well, I don't think you should, but we will come back to it.
You won't know when it's going to happen. It might be when you're in bed tonight.
You won't even know it's a joke.
So I asked you the nickname of Harold Gormson, King of the Danes. Yes. What did everyone put?
Data roaming.
You think his nickname was Data Roaming?
Yeah. King Data Roaming. That would be a name that strikes fear into your enemies' hearts.
Ah, £30 a minute. Jonathan, Chelsea, what did you put?
Well, we were going to say Samsung, and then you said every phone.
I should have said every Samsung. Phone.
Yeah. But then we thought, OK, every phone. Then we thought, what is on every phone? Well, it isn't something that's on it when you buy it. It's something that gets on it afterwards. And that might well be, this was Chelsea's brilliant idea, fecal matter.
Because, you know, brilliant?
Yeah, you see? It's a brilliant idea.
Where's your phone been?
If you flush a toilet, fecal matter is in the air for, like, 500 feet.
500 feet?
That's, like, 3 meters or something.
OK, let's go to the sensible team. I never thought it would come to this. Noel, Richard, what have you got?
Bluetooth.
All day.
That is the correct answer.
Oh. Makes more sense.
Yeah. They called him Bluetooth.
Shit, yeah. Was in right after all.
Yes, sir.
That's the room for Harold. That's the room for B, Bluetooth. So that was his nickname, Bluetooth, because he was addicted to blueberries.
He was called Harold Bluetooth or something, wasn't
he? Well, why did you write data roaming then?
No, I put Bluetooth in brackets on the end.
Oh, have you? Jack's oh, no, OK, you did, yeah.
Your nickname's Newtooth, isn't it?
King. Nice. So at the end of the first round, let's have a look at the scores. Jonathan and Chelsea have 3, Jack and Mel have 4, Noel and Richard have a full house with 5. It's killing it. We're just going to take a short break. See you in 2 minutes for more of everything. Welcome back to the Big Fat Quiz of Everything. Our next round is all about film. Citizen Kane is often cited as the greatest film ever made, presumably by people who have never seen The Goonies. Of course, the most famous boxing film of all time is Rocky, where against all the odds and despite a swollen lip, puffy eyes and a totally battered face, Sylvester Stallone was cast as the lead.
No, that's not fair.
What, to
Sylvester Stallone's a god of cinema.
Oh, he's ghastly.
What?
Sorry, lads. Ooh, I'm sorry.
Chelsea, where do you stand on Sylvester Stallone?
Over his face?
My favourite scene in any film is The Expendables, where he has a conversation with Mickey Rourke, and it's like the scene is being conducted underwater.
Okay, for my first question about films, I want you to tell me what links the following movie quotes. Luke, I am your father. Mrs. Robinson, are you trying to seduce me? And do you feel lucky, punk? What links those three lines?
Or if Sylvester Stallone is doing them.
That's not very good. Sly is more like. That's good.
There's the Billy Idol. There's the Billy Idol.
It's deeper than that. That's the Elephant Man.
No, the Elephant Man. The Elephant Man.
I'm not your father, Luke.
That's the Elephant Man.
Well, that's why you don't like Sylvester Stallone. Because you haven't seen it.
Okay, write down your answers. We're going to have to call time on doing impressions of Sylvester Stallone playing. Who you're doing.
He's got those kind of strange, pouty things.
This is the best one so far.
More quiz. Next question. Take a look at this clip from Raiders of the Lost Ark, featuring a rather hot and sweaty Harrison Ford as Indiana Jones.
Brilliant.
It's good, but he's no Stallone.
So, a classic sequence from Indiana Jones. Originally, that was supposed to be a full-length fight scene. What circumstances led to it being cut short? Yeah. Write down your answers.
I do know this, but you know what? I've forgotten. Can I still get a point?
Yes, we're doing a special version of the quiz for you.
Forgetting something is the same as not knowing.
No, because I did know once. I definitely knew this. I definitely knew this.
That's the same as not knowing.
Mel, what are you eating?
What is that?
Kendall mint cake.
Mel, are you from another age? Kendall mint cake.
I knew this was going to be a long haul.
Yeah.
We're not climbing Snowdon. What are you thinking?
What is that?
It's Chelsea. Like,
oh, try some.
From across my pond to your pond, get involved.
Chelsea, by the way, takes confectionery off her, but if Jonathan offers you anything, don't take it.
Okay, so no on him, yes on him. Yeah. Like, this is not a snack that gives you sustenance.
No.
It's pure sugar.
Yeah. It's pure sugar, love.
It's essentially just sugar.
It's great.
For our next question, it's over to musical maestro Gareth Malone.
Hi, Jimmy. Now, one of my favourite films has to be Close Encounters of the Third Kind, where they use that wonderful music, bom, 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 to communicate with aliens. Now, if that was a Close Encounter of the Third Kind, what are Close Encounters of the First and Second?
OK. Close Encounters of the First and Second Kind.
I like Gareth.
He's fit, isn't he?
I don't know what was in that Kendall mint cake, but my anus feels very flat.
It's so sugary.
As relaxed as it's ever been.
In that case, Mel, I will have some after all.
Have a look at this still. It's a scene from Steamboat Bill Jr., starring Buster Keaton. According to legend, his shoes were nailed to the floor when they were filming this, but why?
Oh, because he had hammer toes.
That's one of the worst jokes I've ever heard in my entire life.
What did Chelsea just say?
I'm not telling you.
I'll tell you.
Yeah.
Because he had hammer toes.
Okay, next question. Take a look at this.
Yes.
I'm really. Enjoying.
It's been used in loads of movies. What is it?
What is it?
It's a waterfall. It looks like the Game of Thrones chair.
Doesn't look anything like that.
It does.
It doesn't look anything like that.
He's turning on me.
But did you think...
I was told he was a nice old guy.
But listen.
Now he's cutthroat.
Well, no, because listen, if you want me to write that, I'll write it. But no, one else.
Don't do me any favors.
Chelsea, don't worry. Jonathan has never peer pressured a comedian into doing something they regret.
All right. You all got something?
Yeah, you bet.
Okay. So I asked you what linked the famous movie quotes. What did you put?
What connects me is they were all lines written for the actors by other people.
Well, if you thought their answer was stupid, Mel...
What?
It's not stupid.
What did you put? Managed to outdo them, if anything. They are all famous film lines. And he thought, I know what'll save this. Sneak in a little favour.
Yeah, I went a bit blank. Exactly.
Noel, Richard, what have you got?
We're straight up facts here.
Oh.
They're not the actual lines.
That is the right answer.
Bam.
Oh my God.
They're all famous misquotes. So it's Luke, I am your father, is the misquote. He actually said, no, I am your father. Mrs. Robinson, you're trying to seduce me, was Mrs. Robinson, you're trying to seduce me, aren't you? Do you feel lucky, punk, is... You've got to ask yourself one question. Do you feel lucky? Well, do you, punk?
Yes.
Yeah.
That was the right one.
Abbreviated.
Tip-top. Yeah.
So you get the points, Noel and Richard. Well done.
Thank you.
OK, I showed you a classic clip from Raiders of the Lost Ark and asked you why that scene was cut short.
Boom.
Mayonnaise.
Dysentery. Dysentery.
What? She's got it.
Dysentery?
Not you, not a dysentery. You've got the... She's got the answer.
Dysentery. Harrison Ford, who was in that film, in that clip...
Yes, we saw him. Yeah.
Yes. ..had a very dicky tummy throughout the filming. This was a scene that was too long for him and he thought, oh, I've got to get myself to a cubicle.
He had the shits.
He had the total shits. So, hence, Chelsea,
yes.
Bear with me. You've gone a little bit glassy-eyed, love.
Sorry, still... my bad.
So, Harrison thought, sod this for a game of soldiers. Yes. I'll get the gun out.
Sure. OK, and what did you put, Chelsea?
Well, I had forgotten this answer, but Chelsea got it correctly. I believe we agree. He was sick that day. They couldn't film the long fight sequence.
Yeah, but she didn't put dysentery, though.
Well, because we're polite.
OK, Noel, Richard, what did you get?
He had pneumonia or something. We didn't get
it. I said dysentery, and you put pleurisy, you idiot.
I said, no, that's me trying to write pneumonia. Don't...
Look at your doctor's handwriting. No-one knows what you've written. Love. I do calligraphy.
Look, love, let's just sort this out in the car on the way home.
What did you think? The answer was Harrison Ford had dysentery.
Yes.
Jimmy, you know I'm honest, right?
Yeah.
I did say can you put dysentery down? And, you know, he just goes his own way. He's an idiot. I know he's directed loads of films, you know, sometimes...
Sometimes I don't... I'm too in my head, or I don't engage, or I don't listen. And I know you're saying it, and I'm trying to hear it.
This is why the marriage broke down once before.
I acknowledge that.
I mean, it wasn't just that, you know, the sex had gone wrong.
The sex had changed.
With your fairness, Noel, if we had to describe your vagina, it is an outie.
Wow! What's going down now?
Talk about
my vagina on television. My nan watches this show.
Let's move on. OK. Gareth Malone asked you what you thought a close encounter of the first and second kind was.
We put first kind is sighting, second one is hearing. So you see it, then you hear it creeping up on you, then you meet it.
New.
Base one is tongue kiss, base two is tit up.
A close encounter.
Yeah, like with aliens. You tongue kiss the alien, now you've got to the close encounter base one.
What do you mean by tit up?
Breasts.
I know what they are, I know what tits are, but what is tit up?
To tit, you touch their breasts.
Oh, tit up.
I know, I'm not... I know...
What's the up component?
What's the up component? Exactly, Richard.
You put it up her blouse.
The tit is already there, you never put it up the blouse.
No! To put it up the blouse.
The hand.
Oh, why am I titting myself off? Could have just explained it.
Tit up sounds like you're either adding more tits or you're forcing the tits higher than they ought to be.
Exactly. I'm seeing a kind of balcony shelf type thing.
My friend from Essex told me about it.
Enough tit up talk.
Yes.
What did you put, Noel, Richard?
Tit up.
Sight.
Yeah.
Physical incursion.
Oh, well,
touch up.
I put not tit up.
That is 100% correct, Noel and Richard. A close encounter of the first kind is a sighting.
Yes.
A close encounter of the second kind is a physical evidence. I showed you a picture of Buster Keaton. Why did he have his shoes nailed to the floor? Chelsea, what do you think?
House falls down.
Because it falls down over him and he had to stay exactly in that spot because he needs to be precisely there so he doesn't get crushed and the window goes right over him. Goes right over him.
Jack, Mel, not great body language. What's going on here?
Jack is sitting this round out, Jimmy. After the...
Tick gate. I'm sorry for what I wrote and I'm sorry for what I said.
Jonathan, Chelsea, I got exactly the same as you. I put because house fell down.
Why has everyone started talking like Tarzan? Because house fall down.
The building falls over him and it had to be matched up precisely.
Wow.
Whoa.
Wow. Well, let's take a look. Still good now. No, well, you all got absolutely right. The house fell down.
Can I just say that I think Mel's taken her shoes off? It's true. No, that hasn't nailed them down, but I think she was about to.
I
They're the cutest shoes I've ever seen in my life.
Thanks, love.
I'd like to drink Baileys out of them.
Oh, you can. You can. You will. You will and you can.
I showed you this object. What was it?
A producer.
I think that's the best joke so far. I feel that's a joke of the show.
I think that's really strong. That's really strong, that.
Jimmy hates it. Look at him. Yeah. Every bone in his body is screaming out, that cannot be a producer. It's a metal object on a on a plinth. How could it be a producer? A producer's a person. Yeah. Look at him, Captain Logic melting from the inside as Dr. Abstract comes down on him like a whimsical penis.
You're going to fizz now and start puking milk, aren't
Look
you?
Look at him, the Federer of comedy with his... Gaze, look, can't take it, can't compute. No, mustn't, no, no logic. This, no producer, this
Tarzan
metal.
It's the joke of the show. I'll say it again. It's the joke of the show.
Yes.
Around this joke, we build the show. We build the show outward from this joke.
What did you write down, Richard?
It's kind
producer.
Of like, isn't it a bit like a sort of theremin-y sort of sound device.
Theremin-y sound device. Chelsea, Jonathan, what did you get?
We put down it is an instrument and we believe it's used mainly in horror films, so we got it right.
Instrument, horror. Yeah, I can see that. Okay, you get a point for that. What did you put, Mel? Jack?
Digging your shoes off.
Now.
When are the pop socks going to come off as well?
Later. Oh, that's wrong. Grandmother and grandson. It's a water phone.
You're absolutely right.
It's a really cool thing, and I'd quite like to have a go on it.
Go ahead, if you want to have a go, have a go.
I haven't got performance trousers on.
You can stand behind the plane. Come over.
It's... Very quickly. Richard, you look
I'll
cool.
You
look cool. Cover me to the plinth. There we go. Cover me to the plinth.
He's like his
That's good.
Okay, now we're sending him back.
Thank you. Good. Okay. No one noticed. The terrible news.
Okay, now play us. Knock out a tune. So this is used in loads of horror films.
Yeah, it's mainly horror films.
It's used. It's brilliant actually, because you can use it on the bottom.
No, that's not how you. That's not how you use it.
Shouldn't it be the bow side?
Try the bow side.
The other side, Mel.
Mel, the bow.
I was coming to that. I was coming to the string bit.
There we go.
That's better. Thank you.
There she was.
Do you know what they call this in the industry? Combing the producer's hair.
Shuffle away.
Get me back. Cover me.
Shuffle
cover
back.
Me.
Shuffle
cover
back.
Me.
Let's shuffle back.
Cover me. Thanks, brother.
Shuffle back. Very funny.
OK, let's take a look at the scores. Jonathan and Chelsea have 6. Jack and Mel have 7. Noel and Richard are in the lead with 10. Who had that? Time now for some ads. More hot, big, fat quiz action after the break. Welcome back to the Big Fat Quiz of Everything. This next round is all about science and technology. In 1928, Alexander Fleming discovered penicillin. The discovery was just in time, as he'd also recently discovered 18 to 30 holidays in Magaluf and needed it urgently. In 1953, James Watson and Francis Crick successfully mapped DNA. Their discovery has led to some incredible advances in gene splicing, resulting in the world's first ever human-crow hybrid. Noel Fielding, everyone.
Unbelievable what you're doing tonight.
What have I done?
You avert your vaudevillian eyes from my dear wife.
Let's have a look at some of the most groundbreaking inventions in history.
3, 2, 1. Liftoff. We have a liftoff.
Man's age-old dream of flight becomes a reality.
1985, they reckon, is going to be the big year for the bubble.
Now someone has invented a bowler which gives more than moral support.
It is, in fact, a bulletproof shield.
Dictated in Morse and printed out in plain language.
Imagine a world where every word ever written could be viewed instantly in your home via an information superhighway.
And today we're introducing the iPhone.
I
I love that show.
OK, here's some science and technology questions. You saw some incredible inventions there. What I want to know is, what did Alfred Nobel, founder of the Nobel Peace Prize, invent in 1867, which earned him the title The Merchant of Death? Look at... Oh, Mel's thinking.
Oh, I know.
I think Mel might have it. OK, for our next question, ruddy hell, it's Paul Wirehouse.
Hello, Jimmy. My fantastic showbiz chum. Even though I've actually only met you once. As you know, in 1969, Neil Armstrong became the first person to walk on the moon, closely followed by Buzz Aldrin. But when Buzz got to the bottom of the ladder, what did he become the first person to do on the moon?
Wow.
I want to write... You know what I want to write.
Jack, don't write
it. No, I want to write it, and I'm... But I'm not going to do it. I'm going to be better than that. I won't write it.
Jack, we've got to write
because
something.
Because you know what? I've been in this show for 5 years now, yeah. And every time I fall into the trap of doing it, and I'm not going to do it. I'm better than that.
Jack, come on.
No, I'm a grown-up, and I'm an adult, and I've read books now, and I'm not writing Moonwank. We can do something else.
Do you want me to write Moonwank?
No, no, I don't want to write it. We're better than that. Put shit.
OK, take a look at this man being interviewed by Patrick Moore on the 1969 magazine show One Pair of Eyes. What does this man claim he is able to do? That was Noel's dad being interviewed in 1969. What did he claim to be able to do?
At your expense.
Fair enough. Next up, we have a very special treat for you. Joey Essex has made a documentary about one of his scientific heroes. Who on earth is he talking about?
Hello, I'm Joey Essex, and I'm here today to talk to you about a very famous man who'd done a load of stuff. He was the king of scientists. He invented everything before anyone even thought about it. So this thing's like a car inside a pie. Pie car. A tank? What? He's very old. I think he's about 105. What? That ain't a helicopter. I don't think you'd get in there. You'd look like you'd chop your head off. He does this certain look that I like to call hashtag screwface. He sort of means like this. He was a really good drawer as well, just like me. I got a C in art, and that's a pass. He done this picture where this lady is really, really smizing. And if you don't know what smizing means, it means smiling with your eyes. She seemed very confused, like one of them girls that you look at sometimes. You see her in a club and you think, does she fancy me or does she not fancy me? And you think, nah, she don't fancy me. But then next minute, she's trying to get older. She's that sort of girl. So, there you have it. A guy who invented life. He painted pictures for a living. He had a long beard. He was quite boring. He was clever like me. And in my opinion, he's a proper geezer.
Actually, so what I want to know is who was he talking about?
We got it.
We're done.
You're done?
We wrote it down while we were watching it.
Huge. OK.
Can I just say, this should be big fat quiz of the 90s for some of the references we're laying down.
We've done some quite amusing things with this one.
Yeah.
Quietly Ooh. Confident, Mel Giedroyc.
Yes. I've gone smug. I'm so sorry. I'm
no,
not
I love
really,
it.
I've gone really smug.
Welcome to Humour Town. Population 2.
Oh, Nana's getting frisky.
Overstep the mark.
Don't let that fucking cyborg speak to you like that.
Did you just call me a fucking cyborg?
I said, don't let that fucking cyborg speak to you like that. That's what I said.
I've never heard you swear, Richard. I don't like you swearing.
Well, don't be fair, he's been pushed quite far tonight.
I have been pushed quite far by...
Yeah, by the
fucking I'll try and say something nice. Look, I really like your wife's blouse.
Wow, look what you're doing again.
You're doing that thing where you fancy me and you're pretending not to.
It's time for a Say What You See. Have a look at these.
Oh, okay.
What scientific really story are the pictures spelling out?
Earth back spider.
That's it. Yeah. It's a tough one. This is a tough one.
Yeah. Almost certainly the correct answer.
Yeah. Right, time for some answers. I asked you what Alfred Nobel invented. What did you all put?
Chicken dippers.
I've no reason to assume he didn't invent the chicken dipper as well as...
Dynamite.
Dynamite.
This stuff is dynamite. What did you get, Jack and Mel?
We're in Humour Town, and you're just about to check into the Humour Hotel.
So what did Alfred Nobel invent? It was...
Miss Dynamite. Dynamite.
He left me hanging.
What did you put, Jonathan? Chelsea?
Well,
Chelsea, what did
we
you
had a bit of a disagreement. I studied history, I figured dynamite, but Chelsea was adamant.
Well, his name was Alfred. I thought perhaps the deadly monster he created was the television character Alf.
Points all round, it was dynamite.
Yes.
I asked you what Buzz Aldrin did first when he walked on the moon.
He pee-peed in his pants. In his spacesuit, you know.
100% right.
We got that as well.
I did that at the beginning of the show because it was cold. Sorry.
He pissed himself, OK. And then you've got Noel and Richard.
It's space panties.
I hate that word.
Why don't you like the word panties?
It's sweet, it's a
panties. It's my absolute favourite word.
How are you with the word moist?
Fine, actually fine.
Fine with moist.
She works with Kate. Panties. She has to like
Stop
moist.
Stop it.
What about if we changed it to panties? Hi. Could you show me your panties?
That's even worse.
That's very
worse. That's much worse.
Excuse me, I find your panties quite moist.
Oh, God.
That's arousing. That's arousing. That's better. That's better for me.
Weirdly, you pushed it so far, it worked. OK, let's go over to Buzz Aldrin for the answer.
Wow.
OK, I'm on the top step. It's a very simple matter to hop down from one step to the next.
So that's when I decided to take that period of time to take care of a bodily function of slightly filling up the urine bag.
He boldly went where no one had gone before.
So I showed you a clip of a man being interviewed by Patrick Moore. What did he claim to be able to do?
Well, I thought he was speaking Welsh. But apparently, Nell has other ideas.
No, I just thought he'd eaten too much Kendall mint cake.
What do you think, Chelsea?
I thought he could do an auction for a blowjob while giving a blowjob. Is that admissible?
It's quite a specialist skill.
Yeah.
Brilliant.
But I don't think we wrote that.
I'm nailing my feet down. That's
talking
an
alien language because we want to beat those two over there.
Yeah. We almost did the same joke. I put work in an auction and then stop erections. But yours was
it's
a combination.
Opposite joke.
I know. Yeah.
Opposite
track. So you didn't realise?
I know. Shock horror. We didn't get it right.
Look at the handwriting.
Ah.
At least you can read it, Dr. Ayoade.
Save it for the car. On the way home.
Oh. Oh, let's take a look.
What does that mean, actually?
That means, how are all you? I am very pleased to see you this afternoon.
How many languages can you speak?
I can speak altogether three of the space languages. One is Venusian, the second is Kruger, the planet Kruger 60B, yes. And Pluto.
Be claiming to speak three alien languages and still you're not the weirdest guy on the sofa. Amazing, right? Incredible.
You saw Joey Essex giving Brian Cox a run for his money. Who on earth was he chatting about?
Da Vinci.
Da Vinci. Well, you're absolutely right. Leonardo. Did you get it?
Well, Mel has gone... I mean, Humour Town has just been twinned with Giggleswick over here. Oh, my Gag Central. She's just pulled the pin on a lols grenade. Prepare for hilarity.
Come on.
Go on.
I put Leonardo DiCaprio, exclamation mark.
Hilarious.
Leonardo from Ninja Turtles.
Oh, Rufflecopter. Exclamation mark.
And then I put the real one, Leonardo da Vinci.
Well, that's funny, but factual.
We had a lot of fun on the way, and then we got to the right destination. That was terrific.
Boomy.
Richard Noel.
Straight up fact. Leonardo da Vinci. No jokes. Straight up.
I showed you a Say What You See, spelling out a scientific story. What did you all get?
We thought it was Failure Bunsenly, Cotter Earth...
Failure for... What, sorry, but...
Yeah, he's a tennis player. His bands were failed.
Very mean.
Well, we decided to split the chore and do half each, because we figured that's how a team should work, that's how a partnership works. So I took the first part. I thought Tim Henman, Bunsen Burners Bruce Lee, Tim Burners Lee, and then my partner took the second half.
Starring in world-renowned Titanic.
How did you...
That's the famous Titanic.
Yeah, that's the poem.
Titanic.
Yeah.
Jimmy.
World-famous Titanic.
That's famous.
Yeah, but what's the spider then at the end?
He was on the ship. Yeah. One of
them. Noel, Richard, what did you get?
We had a bit of fun towards the end here. So we went Tim Berners-Lee, worldwide spider, and then we pulled it back because we're having a lot of fun, but we thought we're quizzing, so let's actually exactly buckle up for this. And we put web, but the bracket was so small you can't quite read it.
Well, I can tell you what it was. Tim Berners-Lee invents World Wide Web.
Funny.
I agree with you.
Okay, no points for you, no points for you, points to you. Okay, hilarious. Time for a bonus round. I'm going to show you three much-revered works of art which have all been subtly improved. Can you tell me what's the masterpiece called? Yes. And for a bonus point, who painted it?
Okay.
So take a look at this first one.
Wait, oh, it's me!
Okay, here's the next one. And finally...
The new melon suit.
Okay, right. Well, let's see what everyone's got. So the first one, what did you think?
God creating man.
Okay, and then second one?
That was Girl with the Pearl Earring by that other bloke.
All right, and the third one?
Another artist, American Gothic.
Okay, so what are the three artists, Chelsea?
Rembrandt, Monet... Whatever.
Michelangelo. Michelangelo was the first one.
Yeah,
then
go on.
I think it's Vermeer. Was it Vermeer?
Yeah, okay. And then third one?
American Gothic, I don't
know. Well, Chelsea will know. She's American. That's a classic.
McDonald's?
It is not by McDonald's. Okay, Jack and Mel, what did you write?
Adam and Steve, first one.
Good.
Classic, funny, lol. Second one. It's pretty basic, but we went for the comedian with the pearl necklace.
After you.
You, pearl
with
necklace.
The pearl necklace made us laugh.
Jism on your chest. Ditto, lols, stop it, funny, heart, hashtag, smiley face.
Then.
And the final one, we went for Rocky Horror Show,
Rocky
which
Horror Show.
I didn't really get, but she wrote it. Anyway,
That painting features in the Rocky Horror Show.
Classic, stop, you're killing me, gags.
Noel, did you get all these?
Yeah.
Go on, what have you got?
Michelangelo, Vermeer and Grant Woods.
Nailed it.
Wow.
Jack and I featured in God and Adam in Michelangelo's Creation of Adam. I was the girl with the pearl earring by Vermeer. And me and Mel were hanging out in American Gothic by Grant Wood. OK, so let's see what that's done to the scores. Jack and Mel have 10 points. Jonathan and Chelsea have 15. In the lead, Noel and Richard with 20. Wow. We're going to take another quick break. See you for more of everything in a couple of minutes. Welcome back to the Big Fat Quiz of Everything. This next round is all about music. Bob Dylan shocked the world in 1965 when he made the jump from folk to electric. It was, of course, one of those defining moments of music that you never forget, like when Elvis died or Kim Marsh left Hearsay. All the best musicians seem to die aged 27. Kurt Cobain, Jim Morrison, Jimi Hendrix. All I'm saying is, it's something for Jesse J to consider. Right, some music questions for everyone. First up, it's over to the Channel 4 newsroom where Jon Snow is reporting on one of the biggest selling singles of all time.
A youth has appeared in court today after police were informed by his mother that he had shot a man in the head. Police say that the accused, thought to be from a poor family, was obsessed with unusual dances and 17th-century astronomers and was terrified of thunder and lightning. The judge ruled that he would never let the defendant go and, in an unusual move, sentenced him to be stoned while having people spit in his eye. In a statement given after the ruling, the boy blamed the devil for his crime and admitted that nothing really mattered to him. Back to you, Jimmy.
Oh, Jimmy, do you want the artist or the song or both?
Yeah. Treat yourself, write both down.
Already done.
Already done? What, huge, Mel? Huge. Good skills. OK. Which prolific musician wrote sexually explicit letters to his cousin, kept a fart diary and wrote a song called Lick Me in the Arse?
I know this one.
What I've a well-known many musician.
Of his, many of his albums.
Next question. Elvis had a motto which he abbreviated to TCB, which was branded on his plane, on necklaces and rings he gave to friends, also the name of his backing band. Can you tell me what TCB stood for?
Yeah, nice. You got it.
Oh, here's a question for you. In 1997, Chumbawamba released the classic tune Tub Thumping, otherwise known as I Get Knocked Down. In the song, they describe drinking several different alcoholic drinks. What are they?
Oh.
What four drinks do they drink in Tub Thumping?
Four drinks?
Four drinks.
OK, good.
You have to get all four for the point.
Oh, where am I?
There you are.
Pissing the night away. Pissing the night away.
She's a witch!
Have you all got something?
Yes.
OK, take a look at this clip of outraged American judge Benjamin Schwartz. What's got him so riled up?
Can you take 14,000 children and pack them in to one stadium, and they know they're coming there to get hysterical? They ranted. They fainted. Their eyes were glassy. Some pulled their hair out. Some tore their dresses. They threw notes of a very undesirable nature on the stage. One newspaper said that the girls stripped off the veneer of civilization.
The veneer of civilization. What an unbelievable dickhead.
Oh, yes. OK, so what got him so riled up?
It's not that.
So what are we doing? Well, I mean, you've got it already?
Yep.
You've
got all the answers.
Yep. All correct?
Yep.
Have you gone to Funny Town at all?
We are permanent residents of Funny Town in this round. Just
we're not.
So you wait.
I'm only renting.
I've bought a little bungalow. Come on.
A bungalow, more like.
A bungalow. Yeah. Oh, I like that.
Yeah, at the beginning it was fine, but now I'm a bit uncomfortable.
OK, let's have some answers, shall we? So, first off, Jon Snow was reporting on one of the biggest-selling singles of all time. What did you think it was?
Bo Rap. Yeah, Bohemian
wow.
Rhapsody.
Wow, you made Bohemian Rhapsody less
Bo
hip.
Rap.
not an easy task. Well done.
Bo Rap.
We agree with you. It's Queen Bohemian Rhapsody. Yes, we do.
OK, Noel, Richard, Bohemian Rhapsody. Shall we take a look? Let's take a look. Beelzebub has a devil put aside. OK, all points all round for that. Well done, everyone.
Strong.
I asked you what famous musician wrote sexually explicit letters to his cousin, kept a fart diary and wrote a song called Lick Me in the Arse. Chelsea, did you get it?
R. Kelly. But we were divided on this one.
I thought it was Mozart.
Same.
I thought it was Alan Jones.
You think Alan Jones wrote a song called Lick Me in the Arse?
Yeah, during his dark period. Before he started doing all that nice...
Floating in the air,
he was like, lick me in the arse.
Well, that would work with the same tune. Lick me in the arse.
Lick me in the arse.
Okay, so much. Noel, Richard, what did you get?
The Proclaimers. I initially put the Proclaimers.
I put Mozart.
Mozart. Well, you all got it. It was Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart, and we have the music here for Lick Me in My Ass.
Lick me in my
ass. We had to sing that at school every morning.
Very different kind of school you went to.
It was the school motto in Latin.
Well, you went to Aslug school, right?
I did. I am.
Are you a bit tired, love?
Yeah.
Yeah. Do you want to go home? Are you all right? You're going to be all right for the next two rounds?
No, I'll be fine. Yeah.
All right, just checking.
Just hold on till we get to the next service station.
It's all right.
And then you can have a little run around, let off some steam.
And exactly. A burger.
And you can have a burger, Jack.
Thank you.
You can. But not another fizzy drink. You've had two.
It would appear Richard Ayoade and his wife have adopted Jack.
We're giving Mel a night off. Yes. Because it's
I
intensive.
I love it when the Ayoades come round.
Thank you.
So nice.
And well, you know.
I'm going to make Jack lick me in the arse.
OK. I asked you what Elvis's motto, TCB, stood for. What do you all get?
Touching cloth badly.
Well, that is ultimately what killed him.
It's taking care of business.
We did taking care of business well, but we're not going to do a Stallone impersonation.
No, that'd be taking care of business.
You got it too? OK, points all round there. What alcoholic drinks did Chumbawamba go for in their seminal 90s song, Tub Thumping?
Well, Mel puts the sweet sherry and port and lemon.
OK, and then what did you get,
Jack? I was there and I knew that it was cider, lager and a whiskey drink. Whiskey drink, no. Lager drink.
I like a what? I like a...
Lager drink.
I like a cider drink. I like a lager drink. I like a...
Whiskey drink.
I like a port and lemon and a sweet sherry.
Have you got them all down there? Have you got four down?
Yeah.
Yeah.
One of them's wrong,
You've
though.
Got cider in down.
Cider drink, lager drink and whiskey drink.
You're missing one. OK, Noel, Richard, did you get this?
Yeah, lager drink. Whiskey drink, Tizer. You put Tizer, didn't you?
I also put Lemsip.
Bailey's, cider, vodka. Whiskey, Tia cider. Maria.
Which is a neglected part of everyone's drinks cabinet.
I like a Tia Maria.
I love a Tia Maria.
I just like I'm the not ashamed to say it. Real men like Tia Maria.
What is in Tia
Yeah,
Maria?
What is it?
Just joy, tears.
Chelsea, what's your favourite sort of cream-based drink?
Oh, I'm glad I didn't say that.
I don't really drink. I don't want people to not like me. I feel like the whole crowd could tear me from limb to limb if I say I don't drink.
You don't ever drink?
Jack, are you all right?
No, but what, like, you don't drink during the week?
Jack literally doesn't understand what you mean.
He can't wrap his head around it. Correct. Or the weekend.
So, wait, what happens?
I know what happens.
You work, and then what
I
happens?
I work, then I go home and I do,
Yeah, this is the bit where I'm having trouble. So you get home, and then what happens?
I embrace my boyfriend.
But you... Oh. What, but when
and
you haven't
dog.
Had any drink and you're with your loved one?
And we watch American television.
How do you have sex?
Chelsea, what did you write after all that?
We had beer, Long Island iced tea.
Cosmo, but then you told us it was four drinks, so we added...
Two Cosmos.
Well, I can confirm it was a lager drink, a whiskey drink, a vodka drink, a cider drink.
Yes!
Yes.
And finally, I showed you a clip of an outraged American judge. What was he outraged about, Chelsea? Surely you got this.
Was it R. Kelly?
It was not R. Kelly.
OK, we had another answer, too.
We went with the Beatles as well.
OK, what did you put, Jack, Mel?
We thought it was Chico's sexually charged performance after he had won the Mercury Prize.
Did you get it? Noel, Richard, what did you put?
Yeah, we put Beatles.
Or Chumbawamba.
Or Chaz and Dave.
Chaz and Dave.
But we did put the Beatles.
No. The Beatles. It was, of course, Beatlemania that riled him back in the day. Mm. So let's have a look and see what that's done to the scores. Jack and Mel have 13. Jonathan and Chelsea have 19. Noel and Richard still in the lead with 25. Time for another quick break. See you in a few minutes for the rest of everything. Yeah. Welcome back to the Big Fat Quiz of Everything. This round is all about sports and games. In 1966, England defied the odds and won the World Cup. It was the biggest ever achievement in English football until last year, when someone taught Wayne Rooney to read. Fred Perry was Britain's most successful tennis player of all time, winning 8 Grand Slams before giving it all up to concentrate on his real passion, making polo shirts for Despite being invented in 1933, the board game Monopoly is still the number one way to find out which one of your family is a total psychopath. For our first question, it's over to gold-winning Olympian Jessica Ennis-Hill.
Yes.
Hi, Jimmy. In the modern-day Olympics, athletes are all about the aerodynamic spandex, but in ancient Greece, it was very different. What were athletes expected to compete in?
So that was Jessica Ennis-Hill. Noel, have you considered Noel fielding Ayoade, like a double barrel?
What?
This?
What, Jimmy? I'm trying to write something. What's happening? This better be fucking good.
Well, she was Jessica Ennis and then she got married, so she's now Jessica Ennis-Hill.
Oh, nice.
So she's taken her husband's name.
Oh, my God, that's the most boring sentence I've ever heard. My semen has literally frozen.
We're trying.
For the next question, I wanted you to take a look at this clip of Muhammad Ali. It's a press conference. What does he say next?
I have wrestled with an alligator. I done tussled with a whale. I done handcuffed lightning, throw thunder in jail. That's bad. Only last week, I murdered a rock, injured a stone, hospitalized a brick. I'm so mean.
I'm so mean what?
You all right, mate? Something happened in the break and he won't tell me what it was. Did something happen in the break?
I don't want to talk about it.
See?
You look a bit distant. What's happened?
Exactly. What's happened?
I did nothing. Tell Mummy what happened. There was an incident in the corridor.
Come back to us.
Really?
What? Yeah. Who?
I was trying to eat an ice ring donut and Jimmy knocked it out of my hand.
Jimmy?
Well, I was so hungry and all I wanted was this ice ring donut and I went to eat it and he just went, no!
You can have one of those.
Is this how they pay you for Bake Off?
Right, who wants what? Do you want cream tea or do you want a chocolate cake?
I'll have a cream tea.
Cream tea.
Mary Berry, is this right? She's just filming a TV show for America, isn't she? She's doing like an American version of it, isn't she?
Well, an American version of the Great British Bake Off.
Well, yeah, and I know.
Is it called like Man versus Cake?
You're jealous because Mary's famous in America and no one knows who you are in America, Jack. Is that why? You've just been out there, haven't you?
You think I'm trying to break America? I'm not trying to break America.
Well, you should try and break England first, then go back and try and break
America. Have you seen the Bake Off?
No, but I look forward to it.
The Bake Off is the best thing, and explaining the Bake Off to Americans in America is just because they can't get their heads around it. And they go, but how much money do you win? How much money does the winner get? You're like, nothing. That's the beauty of it. They get absolutely bugger all. No book deal, no TV endorsement, no giant check. At the end of 10 weeks of blood, sweat and pastry, the only thing that the winner gets is the praise of a pensioner and an apron. Beautiful.
OK, take a look at this incredible footage from 1988 at America's National Aerobics Championships. And this comes with a warning. This may get you super pumped up. Jack, check it out.
Welcome to the 4th Annual Crystal Light National Aerobic Championship Finals, featuring regional finalists from all across the United States competing for the title of America's Best Aerobic Athlete.
We're champions, we're champions, we are the
So those guys are all pretty fit. What I want to know is, what is the largest muscle in the body?
Largest? I know.
Do you know this? Yeah.
Largest or longest?
What? The brain.
Largest, as I said.
Largest.
Yeah. I'm going to play you 3 themes from famous video games. All you have to do is name the games.
Oh, we got this.
Here's the first theme.
Okay.
Yes.
Second one.
I mean, it's so depressing that every round I've been shit at, but this one, yeah. I know all of them.
OK, and the last one?
Angry Birds. Straight up. I'm going to you the mid-second. Oh, I could do this all day. OK.
Ah, yeah.
Well, don't give them the answer. Give them the bloody quiz.
Thanks,
Mel.
Thank you, Mel. You're kind.
You Peretti, do you want chocolate cake, love? I'm calling you Peretti. Do you mind?
I think
that's
good.
Great. That's great.
She sounds more like a maverick cop that doesn't play
Peretti.
By the rules.
Hey, Peretti.
What are you doing?
You got 48 hours, Peretti.
What are the cake options?
Hey,
do you want cake? Do you want chocolate cake or do you want something else?
What's
Peretti?
The other option?
I don't know. I got coffee. I got cupcake.
It would appear Mel can't do an American accent, and neither can you now.
What are you talking about?
We've broken your American accent.
You're not morphing?
What?
Oh my God! We have a new loser.
You're not the only actor with the skill and sensitivity needed to carry off a New York or Brooklyn accent. That would be Richard over there, right there.
Oh my goodness.
Pray silence.
Well, well, well.
Hi.
Sounded.
Nailed it. How are things? How are things?
That's
Should I
interesting.
Hit the how? How are things?
That's very natural.
How are things going in the precinct?
OK, well, final question.
Cookie? I'm doing scene work.
And scene. OK. OK, final question. It's over to Gogglebox's Steph and Dom. We haven't time to explain Chelsea. Just watch them.
Okay. Hello, Jimmy. Now, when we're not in front of the telly, we love to fill our free time with a squiffy parlour game or two.
But can you tell me which popular party game, released in 1966, was accused of selling sex in a box?
So, Jack's mum and dad want to know.
I don't believe
Now, that was a macaron.
That was a macaron. Next time, it will be a muffin.
We got it?
Yeah, I'd put that.
You ready for some answers? You all got something?
Yeah.
First up, Jessica Ennis-Hill asked you what the ancient Greeks competed in.
Naked, open brackets, no panties, close brackets.
100% right. Jonathan, Chelsea, did you get it?
Yes, ancient spandex. Oh,
spandex is a garment.
Yes.
So...
Yes, they got it wrong.
They got it wrong.
Well put together, Miss Marple. Noel, Richard, what do you think?
Birthday suit, balls all loose.
It's so weird that they did it without any clothes on, because anyone who's won, you know, when you won, everything goes everywhere and it's not comfortable, and they must have had panties back then, so they knew what they
Imagine
were doing.
Imagine the relay.
OK, question two. I showed you a clip of Muhammad Ali giving one of his famous press conferences. What line came next? Only last week I murdered a rock, injured a stone, hospitalised a brick. I'm so mean.
He can intimidate a breeze block with a glance. He's going down a masonry route there. Yeah. He's talking about stones, bricks, rocks. We're thinking, what else has caught his eye? A breeze block. Wow. And that's the toughest of all things used in construction.
True.
The breeze block.
You should get one for masonry humour, Jimmy.
Yeah, you don't get enough of it, and it was clean.
OK, what did you think, Jack?
I make medicine sick.
Noel and Richard, what did you put?
I make medicine sick.
Yeah. Oh, let's have a look.
Only last week, I murdered a rock. Injured a stone, hospitalized a brick. I'm so mean, I make medicine sick.
So cool. Okay, I wanted to know what's the largest muscle in the human body?
Gluteus maximus.
Where's the glute? It's not there, is it? Glute. Still wrong?
Glute.
Glute. Oh,
wow. Yeah.
Gluteus minimus.
Oh, I revealed the trousers. I revealed the trousers.
OK, well, that is the correct answer. What did you put?
Well, we had a disagreement, a small disagreement.
What did you think, Chelsea?
I thought butt, a.k.a. gluteus maximus.
OK.
I thought your brain was a muscle. Isn't your brain a muscle?
No. Jonathan, I've done the same as you.
Yeah, I thought it was a...
I thought it was.
Are you a butt or a brain guy? I guess that's what it comes down to.
That's what it comes down to. I'm all the butt
100% butt guy.
Great.
Good to know. Let's move on. It was gluteus maximus. Yeah, your bum. Points all round. OK, you heard three computer game soundtracks. What were they? Chelsea, did you get these?
Yes. The first one was Super Mario.
Yeah.
Yeah, second one was Zelda, Legend of Zelda.
And then third?
It's Angry Birds.
Well, correct. Did everyone get those?
Yep, we did.
Too busy out.
Whoa, 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 hang on, what did you put?
Look, Jimmy, we were out causing trouble. While these guys were...
swatting.
Exactly.
Donkey, we put Donkey Kong, Sonic, Super Mario, fuck.
We don't care, we were tearing up the neighbourhood.
In our corduroy...
I was reading a lot of Sherlock Holmes. I read The Complete in a week. It was one of the best weeks of my life. It's not even a joke.
And finally, Gogglebox's Stefan Dom asked you what party game was accused of selling sex in a box?
There was a board game called Orgy, wasn't there? I think there was a board game called Orgy.
No.
There was one.
No. This wasn't the trick where someone just puts their penis in a shoebox.
There was a penis in a box, yes.
That's not a licensed board game. That's an assault. There are no dice in that box, there are no rules.
Well, there was still something, and I was rolling them around like crazy.
Jack, Mel, what did you put?
Twister.
Twister.
Noel, Richard.
Twister.
You must have known the Twister.
Why are you saying it like?
I would, because it's late and I've gone insane.
Have a muffin.
No!
What the fuck's going on here? What, a muffin in the groin?
I said have a muffin, I shouted it.
Well, this has gone ridiculous.
Jimmy.
No, but I'm there.
No,
to help him.
No.
When he said he's tired, I gave it to him.
The food.
Hey. I was offering you something.
OK. Oh.
No.
Let's not start a full-scale food fight. Truce.
Hey, Chelsea, welcome to England.
You're an animal.
This is a disaster.
Look, I'm trying to deal with everything. Everything in this quiz.
Has anyone got any wet wipes?
All I can say is that's a shame that that happened. Sorry. It's just a shame, that's all. It's just a shame. I couldn't.
Putting a donut! Ring donuts! And I showed off my non-performance trousers. Guys.
Okay. Nice. It's time to welcome a very special guest, all the way from Sky Sports. It's the legendary commentator Chris Kamara. <I'm coming up. laughs> Chris Kamara, everyone.
What are you?
Oh, can you fucking stop?
It was him.
That was Jack.
Okay, Chris, you're a legendary
he's
commentator.
He's an Arsenal fan. He's always going to miss.
Yes, sorry, Jimmy. John. Chris, you got a question for them. What's the question?
Yes, I'm going to demonstrate three referee signals from three different sports.
Oh, great! Yes. Right. Oh, great.
You have to write down the sports that they come from.
Yep.
And for a bonus point, what the signal actually means. Okie dokie.
Okay, first one.
Has this started?
You've got to write these down. There's three of them. What is it? Second one.
Like mine. Cricket.
Yeah, that could be right.
Slightly disturbed.
Yeah, yeah. The third one. Whistle once again.
What's that?
I don't know.
OK, you've got something written down? Good Jack, Mel?
Yes.
We got
when
something.
It goes over the,
Richard, Noel?
What? 1 point for the sport, and then a bonus point for this signal.
OK.
All right, cool.
Was the last one rugby?
The bona fide...
Dude, you can't ask.
No, I was just trying to...
Sorry, son.
OK. You can't walk back into my life now.
I can.
And call me your son.
I can.
You can't do that.
Your mum's been on at me for years.
Don't you dare bring mum in. I'm married now. I'm quizzing professionally.
Really?
I built a life for myself.
OK, so have you got something, Jonathan, Chelsea? Yes, what have you got?
You said basketball...
Travelling.
Yeah, basketball, travelling. What was it? Show us what was the thing again?
Basketball and...
That was travelling, OK. What was the next one?
Well, the next one, Chelsea said, was she was convinced this was when the soccer ball bounces off your knee.
OK, Jack, Mel, what did you get for this one?
Leg by
leg
cricket.
By.
Oh, cricket.
Cricket. Imagine baseball, but even more boring.
Yeah.
And the third one? What did you put,
Touchdown
Noel, Richard?
Touchdown American football.
Touchdown American football?
No.
We said we just thought that was just needy.
Think of Mark Clattenburg in the Premier League when it's play on.
Play on?
It's that, football. That. It's football.
It's football advantage.
Football.
It's yes. football.
Advantage. Football advantage.
Oh, my God.
So, Jonathan, Chelsea get 2 points, Jack and Mel get 4 points, and Noel and Richard get 4 points.
4 points.
Let's have a look and see what that's done to the scores. So, Jack and Mel have 24, Jonathan and Chelsea have 25, Noel and Richard are in the lead with 34. Hey! Ladies and gentlemen, once again, Chris Kamara. Thanks, Chris.
Thank you. Thank you, Jimmy.
Take care, mate. Cheers. Welcome back to the Big Fat Quiz of Everything. This round is all about culture. The first cave art dates back 40,000 years. My girlfriend likes cave art. Well, I say cave art. She's out of a jazzle. In the 60s, pop artist Andy Warhol said everyone would be famous for 15 minutes. Since then, Steve Brookstein's managed to get it down to less than three. Right, time for some questions. For our first question, it's over to the one and only Kevin MacLeod.
Hello, Jimmy. Now, as you know, architecture, like art, can engender a whole range of human emotional responses. But can your teams tell me which structure, when it was put up in 1889, was described as a truly tragic street lamp, a carcass, and a hole-riddled suppository?
Kevin MacLeod there. OK, so what he wants to know is what was being described?
Oh, I know what it is.
What is it? That man has a poetry to him that none of us will ever match. That's not a joke, it's just true.
It's a brilliant show.
He's a genius.
It's so good.
No, he's a genius. I love him.
Have a look at this photograph from 1838. What is so special about it? Oh, no, just write down. Yeah. Remember, Mel.
Yeah.
Like Got every it. Other question in this quiz.
Yeah.
OK, next question. The hit musical Cats made its West End debut in 1981. What I want you to do is name three of the cats. Three cats for 1 point.
Which ones are they? Do you know it?
I don't know.
Okay. You only have to do three.
OK, three cats.
Next right. question, please, Jimmy Carr.
OK, for our next question, it's over to the lovely Darcy Bustle.
Oh,
lovely Darcy.
Hello, Jimmy. Now, we ballet dancers have a few unusual habits. One, which is saying merde to each other, which is a rude word in French. But why do we say that?
So why do ballet dancers say shit to each other?
Is it when their coach
yes.
psychologically destroyed them?
Salvador Dali was well known for his weird and wonderful paintings. Dali had an obsession with Hitler, so much so that he drew a portrait of him. What I want to know is, what was Hitler doing in the Salvador Dali painting of him?
1975. These questions are potential minefields.
Can I just note for everyone on this question, Salvador Dali and Hitler were involved. Behave.
Get laid for that.
OK, we're ready for answers. Lovely Kevin MacLeod asked you to describe what was a truly tragic street lamp, a carcass and a whole riddled suppository. What did you think it was?
Jimmy's house.
Nice. Noel, Richard?
Eiffel Tower.
Eiffel Tower. And Jonathan, Chelsea?
Eiffel Tower.
Eiffel Tower.
Points all round.
Woo! Lovely.
I don't remember that grand design.
I showed you a very important picture. What was so important about it?
Big answer coming up.
It's It's the first photograph featuring a human person. It took 7 minutes because they were actually down on their knees polishing their shoes. It's called Le Temple du Boulevard, and it's an early example of Daguerre.
Holy shit.
Smug.
Oh, yeah, you real smuggins.
Yeah, you got the gist of it, yeah.
Is that right?
Literally every detail.
But I knew the theme tune to Zelda.
And then, Jonathan, you've got...
We put first photograph, blah-de-blah-de-blah. We knew all the other shit, but we didn't want to waste your time, Jimmy.
Incorrect. What did you put, Nolan Richard?
First photo taken.
It wasn't, was it, the first photo taken? No, it was the first photo taken of a human being. That, here they are.
It's not a great photo, is it? It's one that you'd throw away. You'd get one of those stickers from the chemist going, this is fucking rubbish, mate.
OK, so first photo to feature a human being. Very well done, Mel. I asked you to name three cats from Cats.
Oh, well done. Who said you... fucking Garfield?
You could have had Alonzo, Bomb Ballerina, Cacabatti, Cassandra, Cockypit, Demeter, Grisabella, Jemima, Rum Tum Tugger, Sicepan Shanks, Tantamole, Victoria, White Cat, Rumpletzo, Quaito, and Old Deuteronomy.
He's reading them off his phone!
Those are just his mates from prep school.
He's just Googling that shit. No.
Did you just Google that?
Yes, he did. I don't think Jack should own a phone, because this is the kind of thing he sends people.
This is a television show, you're not showing.
I appeared on the cover of a magazine, which doesn't happen much anymore, so I was quite pleased. And then I got this photograph sent to me, Jack doing something with the picture of me on the magazine.
Are those Jack's?
Yes, he put his balls on my forehead. He put his balls on my forehead. Right there.
It's a show ton of people out there just for me and you.
I don't want that in my head or on my forehead either.
Okay, so name the cat. So you just name them all, I think, pretty much. Jonathan, Chelsea, did you get this?
Yes, we got Griselda, Malagatoni, Christopher Robin.
You can't have points for that. Noel, Richard? Top Cat.
Who says Top Cat? I've only just got that. Yeah. It's been
Garfield
up there.
And Tom from Tom and Jerry. And what's the other one?
Dealing.
Mistopheles.
Mistopheles is right.
Hang on, it's Mr. Mistopheles. I won't accept Mistopheles.
Jimmy, they also read all of those off the phone. I saw it with my human eyeball.
Jack, can you tell us all of them again now, as quickly as you did last time?
Yes. Yeah. Top Cat. Grisabella, Panettone, Arancina.
No.
Times of Pasta, you're doing Times of Pasta.
Tagliatelle. Carbonara and Chelsea Peretti.
Okay, so Jack and Mel get a point, no one else does.
How are they getting a point for that?
Because actually, I wrote down Grisabella, Rum Tum Tugger, and McCavity as a thing before Jack started cocking about.
You would be so good in Cats, Noel.
Yeah, thanks. You would be, actually.
I love you, Jack.
I'm right here. I'm right here.
Okay, next one. Darcy Bustle asked you, under what circumstances ballet dancers might say shit to each other? What have you written?
They said it because there was always a load of horse shit outside in the old days of ballet, and they would say, meow, meaning mind out for the horse shit before you, because you're on points and stuff.
No, meaning good luck.
Good, exactly.
No.
What I said.
So, meaning good luck because there were loads of people there, because there were carriages outside, so loads of horse shit. Therefore, okay, fine, you get a point for that. Thank you.
Well, I put manure equals lots of carriages.
Fine, lovely.
Yeah.
So now it means good luck. And what did you get?
Same thing.
Carriages, horses.
Carriages. Sign of attendance, horses defecate. Which they do. They do defecate. Let's move
carriages.
On.
Well, there's no getting away from that. It's entirely correct. Points all round. Yeah. Good ballet knowledge. Well played. I asked you what Salvador Dali drew Hitler doing. What did you put?
It's Hitler masturbating. It's a back view of him. It's really odd.
Wow, you've really studied this picture, haven't you?
Well, let's have a look at it. Let's have a look. I mean, the odd thing really is it's on a bed of horses.
He's having a rum-tum-tugger.
Chelsea, did you know that?
I have prints of this in my home. I think it's just... Beautiful work.
Noel, Richard?
Massaging his length to excess joy.
Which one of us do you think wrote that, Jimmy?
I think it was the geography teacher. OK, points all round for that. Well done, everyone. Oh. Nice. OK, let's take a look and see what that's done to the score. So I can tell you that Jonathan and Chelsea have 28 points.
What?
Jack and Mel have 29.
Good.
Noel and Richard have 37. Time for another breather. We've nearly covered everything. See you after the break to find out what happens in the end. Welcome back to the Big Fat Quiz of Everything. Our final round is all about the natural world. The classification of animals can be a bit confusing, but basically they come in three types: fresh, frozen, and nuggets. In 1859, Charles Darwin published On the Origin of Species, although I prefer the sequel, On the Origin of Species 2, Evolve Harder. Right, let's have a look at our final lot of questions. For our first question, it's over to dancing queen Alicia Dixon.
Hi, Jimmy. Now, when I launched my own brand of perfume, I became a bit of a fragrance bore. Ambergris is a natural ingredient often found in fancy perfume, but can you tell me what it is?
We know.
That's good, that's good.
I know, he's so stupid.
I think you've got it.
What? What have I done, Peretti?
Oh, nothing. We were just discussing our answer.
Yeah, yeah, and laughing at you. No, laughing at Alan.
OK, yeah. So she wants to know what ambergris is. Chimpanzees share 98% of their DNA with human beings,
yep,
as demonstrated rather brilliantly by this inquisitive little fella. Have a look.
Wow.
Sweet.
In 1960, primatologist Jane Goodall discovered that chimps could do something it was previously thought only humans could do. What was it?
Got it.
Wank.
So my laugh is very slightly chimpanzee-like, I feel.
Yes, it is! Like that.
Okay.
Ow, it's hurt.
Which famous natural wonder is known in the native language as forehead of the sky?
This might be.
Yeah.
Aurora Borealis.
Yeah, Richard, can I just say your wife's got beautiful boots?
Thank you.
they've got a lovely heel.
Wasn't quite worth the ramp up.
Sorry.
They've got a lovely. Hey, y'all.
I do, though.
OK, final question. This is a myotonic goat. It has a rather unusual reaction when stressed. What does it do?
Oh. We got it. Four for four. Maybe. Certainly, maybe two, we know.
OK, some answers. You ready? You all got things written down?
Yes.
Yep.
Noel, could you try and relax, mate?
What?
Just try and...
I'll be honest with you, Jimmy, I'm done. I've got nothing now. I'm just staring. I'm like one of those children. You know, when you get children up for a holiday really early in the middle of the night and they just stare through your soul going... in their PJs. That's what I am.
OK. So, Alicia Dixon asked you what ambergris was. What did you think?
It's the guts of sperm whale.
No.
Guts of sperm whale?
It's the vomit. It's the vomit from the guts of whales.
Oh, is it?
It's whale vomit.
Oh, I thought it was from the guts.
Well, it is from the guts,
from the
gut. I guess.
It's vomit from the guts.
I guess we could give you that. It's kind of...
No,
it's
all... no way.
Come on.
It's not
the guts. It's what come out of the gut.
OK, well, it's whale vomit. I'll give them... OK, whale vomit. It's the right answer. OK, Noel, Richard, what you got?
We went for regret, which is the same. In a way, it's the same as whale's vomit. Yeah.
Regretful. There is a sense of regret when you smell whale's vomit.
You're weighing it up, aren't you, Jimmy? Go on, Jimmy.
Jimmy.
Go on. Go on, boy. Go on, boy. Go on. Go on. Fetch us a point. Go on. Go on. Go on. Go on, Jim. 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 Come back with a point. Here it comes.
Okay, point to Jonathan and Chelsea on that one. Whale vomit was the right answer.
Thank you.
You're such a good sportsman, Mel.
Well done.
Okay, so I asked you what Jane Goodall discovered that chimpanzees could do in 1960.
We put move furniture.
And I put "or wank" in brackets with an exclamation mark. Because I know it's beyond the watershed now.
It's getting late. Nana's getting racy.
Oh. Yeah. So sorry.
What did you say, Chelsea?
No, I thought it was using tools.
100% right.
That's what I put.
Exactly.
Yeah. As I work with tools like I have to do when I come on this show. That's a proper joke.
He told us it was over, he told us he had nothing left, but it transpires he had one more joke in the barrel. OK, I asked you what natural wonder is known in its native language as forehead of the sky. Any idea?
Ant or deck, I can't remember which one.
It's ant you're thinking of, and it's incorrect. Natural wonder.
Oh, I've suddenly thought what it is.
The Aurora...
Aurora Borealis.
Borealis.
Jonathan,
the
Chelsea?
Finale.
Chelsea got
Aurora
this.
Aurora Borealis.
Yes, it is Mount Everest. I mean, the confidence, though, with which you went Aurora Borealis.
Well, because they
had it too.
They also got it wrong.
Yeah, I know. We weren't listening, clearly.
Mount Everest is known as forehead of the sky. Final one.
The you know this.
Just let him...
OK. The myotonic goat deals with stress how? Mel?
It faints.
It faints.
This
Jimmy.
Is so funny. I've seen this on the computer. It's so funny. Basically, whenever a goat.
It's a goat, Jimmy, and it faints.
It faints. Whenever a goat has a little shock or a surprise, no, i.e., a human being coming up to him and offering something, it faints. It is so priceless. It just falls over like a.
Stop, Jimmy.
When you go temping bowling.
She won't stop talking.
When you throw the ball.
She says the goat faints like 14 times now.
She faints. It's so
funny. I think she's
funny.
Broken, Jack.
It's myotonic and they're really sweet and they
and
faint.
So what happens?
They faint.
Oh, really? Thank you.
She's describing a clip we're faint. About to see.
Faint.
She'll describe it again.
I've seen it. It's really funny. I've seen it on the computer.
Oh, you mentioned that, yeah.
I've seen it.
What happens in it again?
They They go sideways, or they go upways, or they go for it's absolutely hilarious.
Jonathan, what did you put?
It faints.
Faint.
Richard Ayoade, what have you put?
I put they become very passive aggressive.
Well, let's have a look and see who's right. OK, we're checking in on the score. So, Jack and Mel have 30. 1 point ahead, Jonathan and Chelsea have 31. Noel and Richard have 38 points. OK, time for the final question on the show. Here to help me ask it is a very special guest. So the dinosaur's got a question for you. I'll translate, shall I?
Yeah. Yeah.
Great.
Here's the question. For 10 points...
10 points?
For 10 points, when the first dinosaurs roamed the Earth, the whole world was made up of just one single continent. What was it called? So I'll ask it again. When the dinosaurs roamed the Earth, the whole world was made up of just one single continent. What was it called?
We've got no...
all right.
T-Rexes are so angry because they can't wank.
Stop doing that!
Just oh, wow.
Oh, God! Watch your hands!
Jimmy!
So what have you all got? Let's see. Jonathan, Chelsea, what have you got?
We've gone with Pangaea.
OK, Jack, Mel?
Your Africa.
Your Africa.
Yeah.
Why would you choose to do a joke here? You're out of your fucking mind.
This is barely a joke.
That's not even a joke.
It's not a joke.
Jimmy, can you lose the fucking dinosaur now? It's killing me.
Noel, Richard, we'd love to wrap things up. Noel, Richard, what have you written?
Of the three of us, I think it's this dickhead that's getting...
That's a good point, well made. So what have you put, Noel?
We don't know. It was pre-language. So why have they called it anything?
OK, well, the correct answer was Pangaea.
Yes!
It was for 10 points.
Oh, come off it.
Time for you to chart up your scores at home. There were a possible 58 points on offer. Hope you did OK. In third place, Jack Whitehall and Mel Goodroach with 30 points. In second place, Noel Fielding and Richard Ayoade with 38. For the winners of the Big Fat Quiz of Everything, Jonathan Ross and Chelsea Brady with 41 points. Yeah. Thanks to our amazing panel, our special guests, and thank you for watching at home. I've been Jimmy Carr. This has been Big Fat Quiz of Everything. Good night.
E4, Chelsea, Peretti, herself, Thursday night from 9, Law and Disorder is back, and it's been too long. Brand new Brooklyn 99. 9 o'clock Friday, January the 15th on Channel 4. It's not this Friday, the next one. Brand new Cats does Countdown. Jimmy back in the hot seat. Next tonight, you fall 18 feet, you're going to A&E.